Today we're off to central Italy and the beautiful town of Sulmona. Andiamo! Sulmona itself is quite well connected to the bordering regions of Le Marche, Lazio, and Molise. Piazza Garibaldi before 1880 was known as the Piazza del Mercato. It's the main square of Sulmona and the third largest in Abruzzo. Located on the western side of the piazza, the current aqueduct was built in the 13th century by Manfredi di Svevia, who inaugurated it in 1256, to create a canal in the center for the transport of the River Gizio. About 100 meters long, this work is the representation of the economic growth of the town and is made up of curved arches supported by sturdy pylons made of local limestone that fed the local mills, served the artisan shops, and supplied water to the city fountains. The aqueduct was resized in the 17th century, cut after the 1706 earthquake for the construction of residences, and then restored further after the Second World War. Sulmona is an Italian town of nearly 23,000 inhabitants in the province of L'Aquila in Abruzzo. Located in the heart of the province at the foot of the Maiella, only 2 hours from Rome, surrounded by beautiful mountains, Sulmona is known throughout the world for its centuries-old tradition in the production of sugared almonds called confetti. The town was originally known as Solmo, a town of the Paligni, an ancient Italic people. It was later a Roman possession and was the birthplace of the first century Roman poet Ovidio. The church was built on the remains of a pagan temple dedicated to Jupiter, and the first historical record dates back to 1067. Legend has it that it was built above the house of the poet Ovidio. In fact, the name della tomba, mentioned since the oldest documents, suggests that the church had been erected over a pagan sepulcher, which must have been located in the central nave. Corso Ovidio is the true main street of the city, and it hosts the most beautiful shops and monuments that wind their way through the Centro Storico. The celebratory statue of the local famous poet Ovidio was inaugurated in 1925. It's located in the central piazza 20 Settembre. Again, Sulmona is famous throughout the world as the city of confetti. The sugary treats were already produced in the Middle Ages, however there is no mention of sweets, but of jam, a term which indicated, among other things, shelled almonds and walnuts covered with honey. Those who come to Sulmona for the first time are delighted by the large number of baskets filled with flowers of colorful sugared almonds, and also in the most varied of shapes. Culturally across Italy, the sweet tends to be enjoyed as part of celebratory events. Light blue or pink for births, red for graduations, silver and gold for wedding anniversaries, and much more. This complex, made up of the church and the annex building, is perhaps the most representative and famous monument in the city of Sulmona, as it encloses and blends, even visually, many centuries of history and artistic expression. The church and hospital were founded in 1320 by the Brotherhood of the Compenitenti, which had above all charitable purposes. Thanks to the help of the powerful and the contribution of the citizens, the hospital became one of the most important in the Kingdom of Naples. The Villa Comunale of Sulmona is a vast garden designed at the end of the 19th century, which extends for a length of almost 1 kilometer. The Villa Comunale is a space dedicated to relaxation and socializing, a space where citizens of all ages can meet and where tourists can take a pleasant break from visiting the city in the shade of the trees or having a coffee at the tables of the bar. The city center has a vast architectural, historical, and cultural heritage, while the surrounding areas are ideal for lovers of outdoor life as they're full of itineraries for hiking, walking, or cycling. The Porta Napoli is the southern gateway to the medieval town, and it was part of the second wall built between the late 13th and early 14th century to meet the new requirements of the town's imposing defenses, which resulted from the population growth and urban expansion. Previously named Porta Nova, most likely because it led onto the ancient Via Nova and defended the south entrance of the city on the important road link with Naples, the capital of the kingdom. Ancient churches, stately palaces, boundary walls that house architectural works of Roman origin, this is Sulmona, a city which, due to its monumental heritage built in different styles, has long been known as Siena degli Abruzzi. When arriving into Sulmona, the train station is quite a walk to the historical center. Inside the station, there's a bar where you can buy bus tickets, where one of the main stops in the center goes right to the Piazza Garibaldi. I hope you all enjoyed this visit to the city of confetti. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.